Okay friends, now let us talk about something about the lamp-brush chromosomes and what are they actually. Now in this kind of video tutorials, we are just focusing on the overview of the materials. So we are not talking about details, we are just talking about the overview. Now lamp-brush chromosomes are normally a kind of giant chromosome which are called the polyteen chromosome, which is found in the developing oocytes of some animals, irrespective of different birds, snakes, insects, amphibians, reptiles and all these different types of animals. It was discovered by Rucker in 1892, R-U-C-K-E-R-T, just no need to remember, but to giving a privilege, okay. The lamp-brush chromosome contains the lateral loops and appears like a brass, as you can see in this picture, okay. Hence the name came from like the lamp-brush chromosomes, okay. So if you look at this picture and demonstrate the structure of lamp-brush chromosome, what we can find here. So this is actually found during the embryogenesis steps, during the developing embryo from the developing oocytes actually. In that case, what happens, the DNA sequence or the DNA materials or genetic materials of those developing embryo start to accommodate much less area at the stage, because they need to accommodate much and much more amount of cytoplasmic content inside their cell, because they need much more cytoplasmic content, because the cytoplasmic content or different organelles inside the cytoplasm can only be gathered from their mother cell, because the father is nothing to give the cytoplasmic content. Father only gave them the nucleus contents. So they need to accommodate a huge amount of DNA inside a small cell. So they need to produce a very efficient structure which can gather much more amount of genetic data into a small area, and that is what exactly helping them to do that using this lamp-brush chromosome. Okay, now why it is called the lamp-brush? Because it just looks like a brush-like structure or bottle washer-like structure. If we look at this case, so this is the actual structure of lamp-brush chromosome. This is the scaling 0.5 millimeter in length. If we can look in this case, and right after that, if we take a snap from this place and look and zoom into it, and we can find some structure like this. So what happens at the middle? We are having the axis. Now, what is this axis made up with? This axis is made up with itself the DNA strands. This axis is really strong and a major DNA sequences, and inside, as you can look at there, that there are different regions, like different points in this axis. These points are called the chromomere. Okay, if we zoom into the structure of this one of this loop structure of this axis, what we'll find, we can see in one axis, as you can see in this case, one axis, this part is the axis, and this axis from a point or junction point with this axis, which is called chromomere, as you can see in this case, from the highly condensed chromatin sequences in this part, and from this highly condensed chromatin regions, two loops are coming outside in both the different directions, in both up and lower directions, and these loops are called the chromatin loop, and they are 10 micrometer in length and very simple small in diameter. So these loops are coming out, and these loops are also made up with DNA strands. So this is the actual DNA strand. So this DNA is finally make these loops, and loops are joined together with this axis via chromomere formation, and finally this whole axis will coil with each other to finally make a really complex and compact structure. We know that inside the cell, inside any kind of cell, like inside eukaryotic cell, we are storing the DNA materials in super helical or super coiling model to reduce the area or amount of area, okay. But in this case, as you can see, this is much more effective than producing super coiled DNA segments, okay, because this kind of arrangement helped them to establish all this, because at this stage they are end up with many huge number of chromosomal information. That's why this kind of chromosomes are really giant, really huge. That's why we call them the giant chromosomes, okay. So you can see here in this gorgeous picture, or fluorescence picture, fluorescent microscopy, and this picture, you can see this is the axis, and this axis is stained with highly fluorescent particles, and these are the red fluorescent tagging of the loop which are coming out, and they are making the lamp-brush chromosome structure. So that is it, and I hope it will help you. Thank you.